Okay, this is how to make paleo treats, that is, treats of a paleo life theme. In particular, we're having a Dry Dredgers Eurypterid class, beginner's class. So the traditional trilobite cookies use Nutter Butter peanut butter sandwich cookies. Okay, here's the Nutter Butter peanut butter sandwich cookies. And here they are on the plate, and you take chocolate chips, in this case the dark chocolate. They pour a pile of Nestle's chips onto a plate, put that in the microwave, and put it in for 2 minutes, maybe a minute and a half. You spread that over the peanut butter cookies, and you take licorice, you cut them in inch and a half segments, and you cut one right down the center, and that becomes a claw. This is going to be a claw for the scorpion. And that's going to go there. If you take the end of it, it's already flared up, so it's easier to use these big fat ends. Actually, just cut out the V shape. Cut into the licorice and pull out that wedge. Another segment is a tail. You have another claw. Okay, so the licorice claws are laid out, tails laid out. Then you have to smother this with chocolate, and you add, take M&M's, this happens to be dark chocolate. You get matching eyes, you put that into the chocolate. Anyway, the end product, it looks something like this. My underwater sea scorpions or Eurypterids, ancient Paleozoic creatures that swam the seas and were hunting down little fish during Silurian times. And this is just a few of them on a plate, and I'm going to make enough for about 50 people. Okay, there's a few ways to go about this. The chocolate can be dabbed on, and this is placed right into the gooey chocolate, and you're putting it on to the top. You're putting a lot of chocolate on. When that is chilled in the refrigerator, it'll act, as it becomes hard chocolate, it should, in theory, hold it in place rather well. And so, in this particular one, it's resting firmly on top of the chocolate in big chocolate gunks. You can then take the side of the knife, and you can actually make little striations. Give it an appearance here. I'm almost out of chocolate. You have to hold back dark chocolate brown, or you make little tiny stripes on it. Anyway, you get the idea. Now, I will mention that to get the claws to be open, I cut these down the center, and then I almost cut it off. That is, it's barely hanging on there. It's strong enough not to fall off, but now it's cut well enough that it opens up easily and looks like a claw. And that's kind of what you want. If you don't do it that way, then it stays too close and it doesn't resemble a claw. So almost cut these entirely off to make them look like a claw. And the tail, I actually took a piece and I cut it diagonally. And so one end is fat and that goes on the tail, and the skinny part, the pointer, the stinger, is the very end piece. And the final touch is you can take the eyes, take your knife, and put little tiny dots for the eyes. Kind of make it look cartoonish. So like putting in little pupils there. There we go. And that's my sea Eurypterid cookie. These are not the fancy made from scratch trilobite cookies. These are just Nutter Butter peanut butter cookies. So these are real simple trilobites. Some you can add antennas with licorice if you feel like going to that step. Okay, my second improvement is to create a bumper to hold the claws up at the same level as the cookie. That is, if you do not, these ones are resting across another piece of licorice that all elevates the claws and makes them parallel with the body of the cookie. And by doing that, it's a firmer connection, and it's just simple engineering that if you've got a good solid connection, they'll hold up much better. These will then get stuck into the refrigerator. When they cool off in either the refrigerator or even the freezer, they'll be good and solid, and then you can take that licorice away. Okay, my second improvement is to create a bumper to hold the claws up at the same level as the cookie. That is, if you do not,
These ones are resting across another piece of licorice that all elevates the claws and makes them parallel with the body of the cookie. And by doing that, it's a firmer connection, and it's just simple engineering. That if you've got a good solid connection, they'll hold up much better. These will then get stuck into the refrigerator. When they cool off in either the refrigerator or even the freezer, they'll be good and solid, and then you can take that licorice away. Okay, the other method is to use the rim of the plate itself as elevation and just turn all the claws outward towards the rim and all the tails pointing inwards, and that works pretty good. Okay, so this is kid tested. Connor's going to be the first person to try a sea retrieve cookie. I'm going to take that one. Eat that one. The claw, it's not really hard enough for the claws to stay on, but he's pretty anxious to try it out. You want to take a bite? How's it taste, Connor?
Good.
Yummy?
Mm-hmm.
Does it taste like ancient sea scorpions?
Mm-hmm.
Or does it taste like chocolate and cookies?
Yeah.
Okay. Now the Whipped cookies now have their proper home. And this is the Dry Dredgers main meeting at UC. Everybody's waiting for the class to get started. And there's Jack Holmeyer, president of the club. There's Ron Fine. This is the door prizes. Alexander won one. We get the
number 10.
Some kind of cool fossil.
20. 46, Keegan Courtney, winner, I should say.
Yeah. Keegan won a door prize,
that's
too.
So, Rubus. Dave Meyer, we'd gladly explain to you what a Rubus was. A man in a white shirt back there with a little microphone mask. Who's ever going to do that? That's it, now.
What you get? What is it? Oh, that's cool.
Our program tonight.
Oh.
I get to introduce the speaker for a change.
Big prize. Big coral. Fossilized coral. Alexander's holding up his blastoid that he won. Turn it around sideways. That is cool. They're like crinoids, but a little bit different. Okay.
Have some sea scorpions from a YouTube video. Them crawling around under the sea. They look very much like their terrestrial counterpart. He's chasing after a fish, Silurian fish. He's about to get eaten by a larger sea scorpion. So the large sea scorpion Eurypterid is eating the smaller one. There's a close-up of the tail. Sea scorpion is coming out onto land. We find some sea scorpions in Ohio, but they're extremely rare. This shows Nigel Marvin going back in time, capturing one by hand. It's fiction, but it's neat to see what it would have looked like. Some of them, these ones were 3 feet long. We do find this type in Ohio. Throws it back in. Largest ancient known arthropods throughout history. The largest found Eurypterid is now up to 8 feet. And there's a giant sea crab. 7 foot long Eurypterid, the largest whole one known. The 8 foot one is only known by its claw only. This is the record breaker 8 foot long one now recently discovered. These are fossil sea scorpions that have been found. John Travolta's past life in Scientology. He used to be a sea raptorid. You can see this on the YouTube's video, Eurythmic Eurypterid on YouTube.